from your newest news, this is the Hunt for the North American Bigfoot, Tennessee edition, with Chief Cryptozoologist Researcher Chris Lully. Two News' Chief Investigative Reporter, Vinny Lully. And weather perspective and research from Two News' The Hurricane Kid, Nick Lully. Broadcasting from the Tennessee wilderness, this Two News documentary starts right now.
Everyone, I'm Nick Lully, live from the G Creek area in the Cherokee National Forest, where just a few moments ago, a whistle was blown to ward off black bears, and after the whistle was blown, incident occurred. Let's bring on our chief cryptozoologist, Chris Lully, with more on what happened.
Hi, everybody. We just had an incident here that is typical of Bigfoot behavior, so to speak. Let me show you this rock. Let's see if we can get a angle down here and tell you what happened. There's a rock right here. You can see it's about the size of a softball. It finished right there. As we were walking down the path, after the whistle was blown, just sort to announce our presence to any bears that might be in the area. Within 15 to 20 seconds, I was behind the rest of the crew and heard a rock that came back over, hit farther up on the bank, and it rolled and came to rest right here. Looked behind me and noticed it, finished seeing it rolling. It had to have been, by the trajectory, it had to have been thrown from the, you can scan up there from the bank, it had to come from that direction. And was thrown right after the whistle was announced, or was blown. Like I said, we tried to announce our presence to black bears.
Well, Chris, why would that happen?
Well, again, this is typical of the Eastern Tennessee Bigfoot. A lot of times it's due to territorial reasons, just to announce their presence, or perhaps to make someone leave that they feel uncomfortable with in the area. That's the best we can explain it. It doesn't alarm us. It's quite expected. I mean, it's happened before.
So this is a true sign then that something is...
Yes, most definitely.
This couldn't have just rolled down the hill. Maybe
you
kicked it with your foot.
No, as you can see, there's biggest rock up here, little pebbles and stuff. We were just simply walking through the middle of the trail, and that rock had hit right here and rolled down. I heard that thud, and I noticed, and I seen it finish rolling, come to rest. So it had to have been thrown from somewhere up there, and like I said, it took place right after the whistle had been blown.
Did you see anything? Did you get a glimpse of anything?
Nobody in the party had noticed anything. We did take a quick look up there, but again, it's very hard to see these creatures. They're so well camouflaged, and they know how to use the woods and its resources to their advantage. And, wait a minute, we're going to go live. Pan up there a little bit. Do you see that? Right through there. I just seen something. We're trying to get something on camera here.
Nick, could you maybe give us a synopsis of what's going on right now?
I'm not sure what our chief cryptozoologist has seen. We're going to try to get some more information from him.
Yeah, I just thought I saw some movement behind those trees up there. There seems to be some smaller trees interwoven, which is sometimes they use those as a blind, much as a hunter would. But I don't know. I think what we're going to continue to do is move on and break away from this broadcast. We just wanted to tell you that we had just gotten here and wanted to bring you news of this incident. But we're going to go ahead and move on now as not to agitate anything that might be in the area. And we'll take another interview further up into the creek as we move on and keep you posted. Thank you.